In a previous video, I reported that the most recent generation of my oldest chili breeding line is finally fruiting. The fruits follow the color pattern of Numex Twilight, which is probably a big part of the genome of this specimen. Although I did cross in 6 different varieties, just for fun. The fruits start greenish-whitish, then they get a purple tint, then they turn yellow, like this one, and then the yellow gets more and more orange, and the final stage is red, like this one. It could stay on for a few more days and the red would probably deepen, but I'm too curious and want to try this out now, how it tastes. Took so long. As you can see, the fruit is relatively small, which is a feature I normally quite approve of, and I expect this to taste mostly like an annuum, because if you had a look at the different varieties I crossed, then the majority of them is annuum, and I expect this to be reflected in the taste and maybe also the heat. But first things first, let's secure the seeds, because they are precious. It took a long time to produce them. Yeah, although there is a Butyulokia crossed in, I do not expect this kind of heat level, so I do not bother with gloves or anything. Yeah, there are quite a few seeds inside. I didn't expect this. In the previous generations, there were often just 2 or even just 1 seed per fruit. But these seeds look very good. No oxidized embryos or anything. That's quite okay. Looks like my good luck chili will go on. Okay then, here we go. Okay, it has heat, but very little, and the taste is rather boring, more like a garden variety bell pepper. I can't remember how Numex Twilight tasted, but I think it might have been similar. Yeah. Well, I didn't breed this line for taste or anything, just for fun. And I'm glad that this line still exists and has produced a sufficient number of seeds already, and there are more fruits ripening, so my good luck chili, old spice, however you want to call it, or this thing here, my notation style, the recent generation. Yeah, no surprises. I was almost fearing that I would have to cough a bit, because it seems that the heat profile of annuums is more scratchy to my throat than the other varieties I normally grow. The super hots, they seem to have a different capsaicin and capsaicinoid profile. But yeah, well, it's not unpleasant, the taste or the heat. It's okay. It's, you could chop it up and put it on a piece of bread or something. It would be pleasant.
I guess. Yeah. Just a quick update on my oldest chili breeding line, which will continue now.
Edge Keep Up serviert werden.